This is Cheshanan. Welcome to Aerotech Solutions. Let's see one more application with microcontroller, which is PC based home automation system. So to get notifications for more videos, please subscribe our channel on YouTube, www.youtube.com/aerotechsolutions, and you can like us from Facebook also. The application is PC based home automation system using microcontroller. So this application allows to give the input from keyboard, and it manages different electrical loads connected with microcontroller. Let's see this top view of application as blocks. It contains different blocks from this application. One is power supply and personal computer interface with RS232 cable from DB9 connector of your personal computer. There is microcontroller unit. It supports to establish serial communication between microcontroller and personal computer. So the four relays I am connecting with GPIOs for four different loads. You can use four individual relay coils. So these relays are electromagnetic switches. This allows to take DC pulse and they can drive AC loads. So this power supply contains the internal sections as rectifier, which means bridge rectifier, and filters and regulator. So bridge rectifier converts your AC to pulsating DC, and filter section allows to filter the ripples which are from converted DC source, and regulator will give constant output irrespective of any input. So most of the devices, electronic devices, works with DC power source. So you need to convert your AC into DC using this power supply section. So let's see the hardware connection, how I connected this relays and microcontroller with personal computer. The four relays I am using here, for four relays I connected four different loads: lamp, fan, AC, motor. And this is my AC source. One end of AC source I given to loads directly, the other end I am driving through these relay coils. So this is your common pin. Each relay coil common pin connected with AC source other end, and all NOs. So NC stands for normally closed. This line indicates NC, and NO pin is connected with your loads. So whenever you are activating your relay coil, then this common connection will get connection with NO pin, so that the AC source will reach to your load other end. One end is already given to AC source, the other end you are driving through this relay coil. And the PC connection should be very clear. You have to manage your RHD and TXD pins from microcontroller. Where this RHD and TXD pins from the other side device, which is personal computer. Personal computer contains one DB9 connector. The back side of your personal computer, you may find one DB9 connector. From these 9 pins, you are not using all the pins, you are using only 2 and 3, which are RXD and TXD pins. And that too, you need to do cross connection with your personal computer if it supports TTL logic. If not, you need to use MAX232 as logic level converter. So this kind of hardware circuit you need between personal computer, microcontroller, which is driven your electrical loads. Now let's see the source code of this application, which is developed in embedded C by using Keil Microvision. So let's see the line by line explanation of the source code. This is my title, and reg51.h, this is my header file of microcontroller 51 families, which supports to use all SFR register names by including this header file. And there is the second line, which is S bit, which is single bit from SFR register. Any single bit you are trying to use from SFR registers, you can use the standard data type, which is S bit. So I am using 4 relays. The 4 relays I connected with 4 individual IOs. Relay 1 P2.0 pin, relay 2 P2.1, relay 3 P2.2, relay 4 P2.3. And here I am taking one serial user defined function which is for transmitting the status of loads from microcontroller to PC. And this is my temporary variable X. Now, main source code logic starts from here. This is main, whereas these are serial communication initialization steps. SCON value as 0x50, which allows to enable your receiving data from external device to microcontroller, and also establish serial communication with mode 1. TIM mode is equal to 0x20, which means you are selecting timer 1 in mode 2. And TH1 is equal to minus 3 indicates it fixes your baud rate as 9600 and timer starts. And what text I am expecting on serial window, which is PC based home automation. This is my application title. And here this is my infinite loop. Once the compilation enters into this infinite loop, program which is keep on executing in this loop. So I am just asking the user enter your input from keyboard. While RI is equal to 0, which is terminates ends with semicolon, which means I will wait here the character received from external device to microcontroller. Whenever the data is received from external device to microcontroller, RI bit from SCON register which becomes 1. So whenever your data is received, the received data which is present in SBUF, so I am taking into temporary variable X. And you need to clear your RI bit to wait for next character. So again, you are expecting your character what you given from keyboard on serial window. You can do this transmission. This is for only user purpose. What is hitting from this keyboard? This is your retransmission from controller to PC again. But while transmitting, you have to wait for TI logic until becomes 1. If TI remains 0, still transmission is going on. Whenever TI becomes 1, data is transmitted from controller to external device. Here external device is our PC. I need to clear this TI for next character. See, the received character which is already present in X, based on this received character, what action you are expecting? If the received character is uppercase letter L, then I am trying to turn on lamp. Suppose the received character is lowercase L, lamp off. So here logic 0, which energize your relay coil, already 1 end is given to power source. Whenever you are making logic 0 to the other end of your relay coil, the coil get energizes from hardware mechanism. And whenever your coil energizes, it conducts with your common pin, conducts with your NO. The simple thing. If you are looking to turn on your relay coil, make it logic 0. So that I am making assigning here logic 0 to turn on the load. If I am receiving lowercase L, then I am going to turn off my lamp as per relay logic. But what text I am expecting on screen? Lamp off. Suppose the received character is capital A, which is uppercase A, then AC on. And lowercase A, AC off. So whatever the character you are fixing on the source code, so as per your logic, your loads will work. So only these characters will affect your hardware. The remaining characters won't affect your hardware mechanism. So if you are hitting any other keys from your keyboard, no response from your loads. If you are hitting uppercase F, then fan on. Lowercase F, fan off. Uppercase M, motor on. This is relay 4, and lowercase M, relay 4 1, which is motor off. So even I am giving another key, capital O, which is uppercase O, all loads on. Lowercase O, all loads off. And coming to the serial function definition, so I am taking the string from this main program as string argument, and I am transmitting each character to serial window by using this for loop. Anyway, string terminates with null character. I am comparing with this null character in this for loop. This for loop continues until each null character. So, and for next new line, I am giving one more value, which is 0x0d, and I'm waiting until di becomes 1 and di 0. And this is your serial function definition. After execution of this, each time if you are calling this serial function from main, so this function is going to execute every time. So let's see the output of this with Proteus simulation tool. So Proteus simulation tool will help us to design your hardware and to check your outputs by linking your source code equivalent hex file. So this source code, this circuit is already designed, and I linked the source code also. But if you are not doing, if you are a fresher, then link your hex file just by double click on this controller. This is my hex file. So your simulation doesn't allow .c or .asm files. You need to create hex file, and you need to link your hex file with the microcontroller. And click on OK. Now you can play. Now let's say this PC based home automation text I got on serial window, because I use serial function in my logic. Enter your input. Now as per your input, your loads comes to on. Now I am giving uppercase L, lamp on. You can watch this lamp operation, which is on. If you are giving lowercase L, lamp off. Next, I'm giving uppercase F, fan on. You can watch, this is simulation. You can place even AC loads in real hardware. If I'm giving lowercase F, fan off. If I'm giving uppercase A, AC on. This is AC load. And lowercase A, AC off. And uppercase M, motor on. Lowercase M, motor off. And if you are trying to turn on all the loads, uppercase O, say all loads comes to on. If you are giving input lowercase O, then all loads off. So this is your application execution by developing your embedded C program on Keil Microvision IDE, and you can link your hex file with this Proteus simulation tool. So this is the best way to begin your microcontrollers programming as a beginner. So for more videos, please subscribe on YouTube. We are in YouTube. Please subscribe our channel from YouTube/EdTech Solutions. Please give your valuable feedback through comment and like and share. Here in different services, we are giving online and classroom trainings, and we will support for placement, and we are doing real-time projects, and even for academic level projects also. So we will support all technical related services with this embedded domain. Online training, classroom training, placement support, and all small scale solutions. Okay, so for any requirement, please get back with this number 9676327118 through your hand phone, or you can WhatsApp us. We are located in Hyderabad, which is KPHB metro station near Kukatpally, Hyderabad, Telangana, India. For any information, please get back with this number 9676327118, and you can write your queries or any requirements through this email ysnanda@edtechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.